Welcome back to the Buckeye State Wales. Today is November 11th, 2022. Today, we're Railfanning at Middlebury, Ohio. Railfanning on the Citrail line. This is going to be an evening, and then going into the night. This is episode 3 of this series. We're not doing a lot of series with Railfanning at night. But anyway, this Westbound Intermodal came out of nowhere. I was just quickly getting out, and then I saw gates going down at Cherry Street. So I thought there would be, like, the gates were functioning. Until I heard a horn on Westbound. And then I saw four visitors on a train, so I thought, oh, that's good. I'm something trailing second. But unfortunately, a NS Gevo has to leave, which is unfortunate because I wanted to see like a 4-hour lead, a freight train, whatever, on an Amsterdam line. A lot of that has changed due to PCC and train positive train control. Yeah. Let's go into the night. Of course, more foreign visitors on this freight train. Of course, positive train control has to have the NS ace leader, which is pretty cool because an ace leader, I don't get pretty much sometimes. Well, there is sometimes, but a lot of them are like leading like animals and stuff like freight train. Nope, this is kind of cool. Less foreign visitors. Union Pacific and BNSF. So that's cool.
Thank you.
Ethanol was heading westbound on the Chicago line. Flight flew up at Middlebury, Ohio. Westbound Intermodal and Autorack train ending up stopping by the crossing on the other side that I was at. My dad was on the other side and I was on this side, so yeah, I was screwed. But by the time he was going to pick me up to the other side, there goes an eastbound for a signal. Here comes an eastbound on the NS Chicago line, finally. This is our first eastbound on the NS Chicago line since, well, I haven't gotten an eastbound since I got here at Middlebury, but it has a CSX rebuilt trailing second. There goes NS-11N, going by military, with a solo engine, AC-44C6M. There goes another NS eastbound on the NS tunnel. This one is a sand train heading for Mango Junction in Ohio. But anyway, it had an NS-9 leading, two CNG loads, and an X-City rail running forward. this would have been our final train at Mirabel, Ohio for the night before we had to go back home. But anyway, it headed BNSF GE trailing second. But unfortunately, today's video will be enough here. Thanks for watching. I'll be seeing you at the Michigan State or the Buckeye State Wells.